Namaste YouTube, welcome to Thought Provoking Days on Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to Hunger Strike by Temple of the Dog.
Let's get started with a reaction to it. I have heard this song a few times, so I never really paid attention to the lyrics.
Okay.
For you, I guess it's completely a first time cinematic honesty action. Let's get started.
Cups already overfilled. Yeah. But it's on the table, the fire's cooking, and the farming babies and slaves are working. The blood is on the table and the mouths are choking.
Your favorites in recent times?
The echo sound and the backup sound was done by another singer, and then
one of your favorite singers has sung this from recent times. Your favorites? Didn't recognize?
No.
Started it off. Pearl Jam's Eddie Vedder.
Eddie Vedder.
Okay, what are your thoughts on the song, the lyrics, the music?
Well, The music was amazing. The guitaring was great, and the voices, they were amazing. They both go well. So they go together so well. That's what I wanted to say. And I love the lyrics of the song. It is so heartening, and it makes you think about it. I like the title of the song, Hunger Strike. I think it's hunger that is stricken a person. Not a strike by choice, it's hunger that is stricken a person. And that's when the song comes into play. I like the lines he says that, I don't mind stealing food from decadence, but I can't fill my cup when my cup is already overfilled on powerless people. So he's talking about two different scenarios. One, when a person doesn't have anything to eat, he doesn't mind even stealing and eating because the person is dying of hunger. He's hungry. But he's also talking about the opposite side of it, that there are people who have everything with them, but they still keep pulling and overfilling things from the powerless and from the poor. They don't mind keep on stealing and stealing and stealing and keep overfilling everything when they have it already full.
Yeah, that's what
so
it's
that's
about.
That's what I gathered. Aspects were there in it.
Yeah.
And it reminded me of stealing, food stealing, reminded me of the movie, Charlie Chaplin's movie, The Modern Times. I'm not sure how many of you have watched it, but in that, it was all about, you know, how things were changing when industrialization just started in the world and how things started changing drastically. I like Adna's role when she, you know, just steals a loaf of bread and how people react to it. It was preposterous for her to steal bread, and police were after her right till the end of the movie just for stealing a loaf of bread or some bananas because they were poor, they were hungry, they were jobless, and they needed food. That's all they needed. They needed food and they were trying to fill their stomach somehow.
Yeah, it's heart-hitting, the lyrics. I heard this song, but I never really thought that it was this intense, the lyrics.
One
of the singers is Eddie Vedder of Pearl Jam. The other one is the late Chris Cornell, who was the lead vocalist of Soundgarden, which is a popular request on our channel. Mm-hmm. Perhaps the next time we react, we must line up a song or two of Soundgarden for sure.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact is that this was quite intense, and I never really thought it was that intense. I think you got it more or less right. I wouldn't have explained it the same way. For me, it's about greed. You know, it's about human greed, purely about human greed. It has nothing to do with hunger.
Yeah.
It's hunger is just a name given to it, but it's more about the greed of people. You know, we get, you know, let's say for this reaction, or the people viewing this reaction, we get this reaction, we publish this reaction, you know, Temple of the Dog, Hunger Strike reaction. And what do we expect for it? What do you expect for this reaction once we publish it?
I'll tell you, from every single reaction that we publish on Enoma, on YouTube platform, what I expect is to convey the message of the song as it is, what I understand of it, in my opinion, whatever I thought it was about. And I expect people who come and watch have similar kind of understanding, or you know, not the same as mine. I don't want imposed interpretations on people, but they too connect with the song in a similar way that I connected, and they appreciate what is going on and appreciate
and
the
music. Does that happen?
That all the time though. Some of the time.
Which brings me to my point, you know, what the problem is at times in life, in most platforms, on most platforms, in most cases, the problem is greed. You know, instead of just making a reaction for the sake of sharing the knowledge, like you do all the time, and I do most times. So when we make a reaction, we are sharing our knowledge, our interpretation, our analysis as two easygoing native outsiders, two counselors, teachers, parents, life coaches, and music lovers from another part of the world to most songs that we react to. So we only expect that. We share the knowledge through our reaction. We interpret it in our own way based on our background, our education, our culture, our experience, our upbringing. But most other people do it. You know, I watch a lot of other reactions. Most other people purely are about the views, are about the subscribers, and that's the greed. You know, the greed that comes.
That too is hunger.
It's sad. It's sad. It's a lot of greed that is there. And, you know, they may not beg for subscribers or views. They may not put promote it and things like that. But the fact is that you can hear it in every single reaction that they do. You know, basically, it's all about the views. It's all about the subscribers. It's all about the glory of having achieved that, got somewhere with a particular reaction. But at the end of the day, what happens after that? Okay, let's take our own example. We crossed 50k views, 20k views on hundreds of videos and thousands of articles in my lifetime I've crossed.
Yeah.
You know, 50k views, 100k views is a cup of tea for me as far as content writing is concerned. I've done it in the past, in the last 20, 25 years. Plenty of times, I can't even count how many times. And I've got 810 million views in the process. It's all documented, it's got stats to back it up. And from Google Analytics, Facebook, and so on, the platforms. So it's not my own statistics. But the fact is, what happens when we cross that 100k? Let's say this video crosses 10k views. In the next 2 months, this video garners 10k views, 10,000 views. What does it do to your life? Does it do anything to you or me? No. We move on to our next reaction. Because our purpose was never those 10k views in the first place. We were not greedy about the views. What we wanted was to share our analysis, our interpretation, to listen to music from all over the world. That is the purpose of
Enoma. And to have somebody who understands exactly what we are doing.
Yes, I'm getting at that. To have someone who matches the same wavelength and perhaps someone who benefits from our understanding or our analysis, our assessment of this song. So that is our purpose. So when we reach 10k, it's no big deal for us. Yes, we do like it. Yeah, I'll be honest, I do like. And the next million views is as important as the previous 820 million that I've already achieved or got. You know, the fact that is definitely important, the next million views. But at the same time, it's just another day. It's just another reaction. What matters is, did we do justice to it? Did we enjoy it? Did we find it useful and connect to our life? Will it help me be a better person today and tomorrow? Will it help you be a better person today and tomorrow? Did we enjoy our time together as a couple of reactors reacting to the music? Did our people who watch this reaction have a wholesome experience, have an enriching experience? That is what matters. And unfortunately, in life, as in this song, this experience that we are talking about is intangible. It cannot be measured. And that is why Temple of the Dog did a brilliant thing by comparing it to hunger, which can be measured. Which can be measured, that a loaf of bread, the pot is cooking, this is happening, the table is ready. So you compare it to tangible things. Otherwise, you will never be able to understand. No one, including us, will never be able to understand what they are trying to say. Bottom line, greed is not good. Greed kills. Greed is not helpful to anybody but those people, those few people who keep on becoming more and more fatted and greedy till the day they die, and then it never stops there. The children do it, the grandchildren do it, and it goes on and on and on till a song like that comes along, and perhaps if they heed the word of the songs, life will change for them and for everyone in their family.
Well, some are dying hungry and some are choking on hunger.
Yeah.
So that's what the song was all about, I guess.
Yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching this one.
Yeah.